Muslim can give regarding the definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the definition of Almighty God, is quote Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4, which says, Kul huwa Allah ahad. Say, He is Allah one and only. Allah as-Samad. Allah, the absolute eternal. Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given in the glorious Quran. Any person says so-and-so candidate is God, and if that candidate fits in this four-line definition, we Muslims have no objection in accepting that candidate as God. The first is, Kul huwa Allah ahad. Says Allah one only. Second, Allah as-Samad. Allah, the absolute eternal. Third is, Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. And the fourth is, Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, given in the Quran, in Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4. This Surah Ikhlas, we call it as the touchstone of theology. Theo means God, logi means study. Surah Ikhlas is the touchstone of theology, touchstone of the study of God. You, for example, if you want to sell or buy certain gold jewelry, and if you want to know how pure is the gold, what do? You go to a goldsmith. The goldsmith takes a touchstone and rubs the jewelry against the stone and compares the color and tells you that this is 24 karat gold. Or he may say it is 22 karat gold. Or he may say it is 18 karat gold. Or he may say it is not gold at all, because all that glitters is not gold. Similarly, Surah Ikhlas is the touchstone of theology. Whichever God you are worshipping, put him to the test of Surah Ikhlas. If that God passes the test of Surah Ikhlas, he is a true God, otherwise he is a false God. The first is, Kul huwa Allah ahad. Let us put Bhagawan Rajneesh to the test of Surah Ikhlas. There are many human beings who consider Bhagawan Rajneesh to be God. Once during question and answer time, there's a Hindu who told me that we don't consider Bhagawan Rajneesh to be God. And I told him, I know that the Hindus don't believe Bhagawan Rajneesh to be God, because nowhere do the Hindu scriptures say that Bhagawan Rajneesh is God. I said many human beings, some human beings say that Bhagawan Rajneesh is God. Let's put this Bhagawan Rajneesh to the test of Surah Ikhlas. The first is, Kul huwa Allah ahad. Say, He's Allah one and only. Was Bhagawan Rajneesh one and only? Was he the only man who claimed divinity? There are hundreds. And especially where the country I came from, there are thousands of men who have claimed divinity. He's not the only one. The second one is, Allah as-Samad. Allah, the absolute and eternal. Was Rajneesh absolute and eternal? When we read his biography, we come to know that Bhagawan Rajneesh was suffering from asthma, from diabetes mellitus, from chronic backache. Imagine Almighty God suffering from asthma, diabetes mellitus, suffering from chronic backache. The third test is, Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is begotten. And we know Bhagawan Rajneesh. He was born in Madhya Pradesh. He had parents, mother and father. And in the year 1981, he goes to America, and in the state of Oregon, he makes his own village called as Rajneeshpuram. And he takes thousands of Americans for a ride. And later on, the American government, they arrest him. And they put him behind bars. And Bhagawan Rajneesh alleges that the American government gave me slow poisoning. Imagine Almighty God being slow poisoned. And later on in 1985, he was removed out of USA, and he comes back to the country of India, in Pune. And the Archbishop of Greece said, if you don't remove Rajneesh out of this country, we'll burn his house and the house of his disciple. So Rajneesh comes back to India in the city of Pune. He goes back to his old center. And he renames it as Osho Commune. And when you go there, you find in that center, there is a samadhi. In the samadhi, on the stone of the samadhi, it's mentioned there, Bhagavan Rajneesh, Osho, never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. Never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. They forgot to mention there in the tombstone that he was not given visas to 21 different countries of the world. Imagine Almighty God coming down to the earth to visit the earth and he requires visas. And the Archbishop of Greece said, if you don't remove Rajneesh out of this country, we'll burn his house and the house of his disciple. And the last test, Valam Yakul Laukufanat, there's nothing like him, is so stringent that no one besides the true Almighty God can pass. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. Walam yakulla hukufanat. There's nothing like him. And we know Rajneesh. He had one nose, two eyes, two hands, one mouth, white beard, just like the human beings. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. Walam yakulla hukufanat. There's nothing like him. For example, if someone says that Rajneesh, if someone says that Almighty God is 1,000 times stronger than Arnold Schwarzenegger. You may have heard the name of Arnold Schwarzenegger, the person who was given the title Mr. World, the strongest man in the world, Mr. Universe, the strongest man in the universe. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. The moment you can compare to anyone, whether it's 1,000 times or whether it's 1,000,000 times, whether it's Arnold Schwarzenegger, whether it's Dara Singh, or whether it's King Kong, the moment you can compare him to anything in this world, he's not God. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. This is the four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, given in the glorious Quran, in Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112. If any candidate fits in this four-line definition, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. So when we present this correct concept of God, most of the atheists, or many of them, would accept this concept of God. That is the reason Surah Ikhlas, according to our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it is equal to 1/3 of the Quran. So now what we understand, that these atheists, they are rejecting the God which they have understood by looking at the other human beings. A God that requires to eat, the God that requires to sleep, a God that requires to rest, a God that can be harmed, a God that requires help of others, a God that can die.